Do you want to know the 10 questions you should be asking the agent who's interviewing to sell your house? Well, stay tuned because I'm going to give you what those 10 questions are and what their answers should be in this video. Hey everybody, David Calhoun. I'm a realtor in the Twin Cities with Keller Williams Integrity Lakes, and today we are talking about the 10 questions you as a homeowner should be asking the agents interviewing to sell your house. If you're new to my channel, hit the like and subscribe button. I post new videos every single week about all things real estate. Your house is one of the largest investments you could ever have, and when it comes time to sell it, hiring the wrong agent could cost you not just thousands of dollars, but potentially tens of thousands of dollars by hiring the wrong agent, or an inexperienced agent more so. So I'm gonna give you the 10 questions here. The first question you should be asking them is, are you full-time or part-time? You want someone who is full-time, who is devoted to selling houses, and that makes a decent living or enough to do this full time. You don't want someone who just does this nights and weekends and treats real estate as just a hobby or passive income. So definitely want someone who is doing this full time. A lot of times agents who work full time have a little bit more experience, are a little more skilled. These are not tried and true facts, but these are things I've found to be true in working with other cooperating agents. The second question you should be asking the agent is, how will you handle a multiple offer situation? We've been in such a seller's market where houses are selling in multiple offers over list price. And so you as the seller can be sometimes overwhelmed with the amount of offers you are receiving on your house. And so you want to ask the question to your agent, how are you going to handle a multiple offer situation? You don't want them to say, well, we're going to take the offer that's the highest, because we all know there's multiple things that go into an offer besides price. You want the agent to look at all the terms of the offer, because price is just one thing. You want to look at the type of financing, who the lender is, the amount of down payment. You want to look at closing date. You want to look at the inspection timeline. There's a lot of other things that go into an offer besides just the price. And so if the agent just pushes you to choose the offer that has the highest price, that might not be the best strategy. Number three is, how many listings did you sell last year? You want to ask this question because selling a house requires a different skill set than just having an agent show a house, write an offer, negotiate the contract. There is an element of pricing, which is, you know, strategy, it's art, it's a little bit of science. There is marketing, so they need to have somewhat of a savvy marketing sense for them to sell your house and market it effectively to prospective buyers. But there's definitely a different skill set from a buyer's agent to a listing agent. But I know both agents are very valid, but you definitely want to be asking the agent how many listings they sold last year. If they only sold one or two and they did 25 deals, might not be the best agent you use to sell your house. Number four is, what is the name of the photographer and stager you use? If they look at you like deer in the headlights, they might not be selling enough houses as a listing agent. They should know who their photographer is that they will hire to photograph your house. And they should know who the stager is to refer you to if you decide your house needs to be staged. You know, I found some agents will take photos with their iPhone. You want your agent to be using a professional real estate photographer to shoot your house to give it the best exposure online. Number five, what do you think buyers are looking for these days? So you don't want the agent to say, well, it depends on what they need. I mean, do they, you know, some are wanting four bedrooms up, some want a pool, some want a detached garage, some want a city. And that is true, absolutely. You want the agent to say, buyers are looking for the best price house in the best location that creates an emotional attachment to that house. Because obviously selling, there's an emotional element to buying a house. And so buyers ultimately will buy the house that they feel emotionally connected with. And so you want to make sure the listing agent is doing everything in their power to make sure your house is marketed to pull out that emotional connection with prospective buyers. Number six, how often do you follow up with lenders and title companies once we have an accepted offer? You want to make sure the agent is doing their due diligence throughout the transaction weekly to follow up with title companies and lenders to make sure we are on track for closing. Number seven, ask the agent, what if the house doesn't sell in the first 30 days? Some agents will say, well, we'll lower the price so that it will sell. Well, that's not necessarily the truth always. Yes, ultimately, all houses sell at a certain price point, but there are certain price points that you might just need to be a little bit more patient with selling. And a lot of times these are at the higher price points. You want the agent to say, well, we're gonna do our research and we are gonna look at showing activity within this zip code or this development or this neighborhood to see how many days on market before an offer is accepted. Number eight, ask the agent for recent reviews. They should have recent reviews from past clients that show that they did a great job. Number nine is, what is your average list to sale price? The list to sale price is how much is the house listed for versus how much did it actually sell for? And this gives you a couple indicators here. How close are they at determining the value of your house? The other thing this indicates is they might be buying the listing, which buying the listing means is, say you're interviewing two agents and one agent can say, well, I can get you $500,000 for this house. But the other agent says, well, I can get you $450,000. A lot of times sellers will go, well, if they can get me $500,000, I'm going to go with this agent. That agent might be buying that listing even though they know they can't get $500,000 for it. And so they might take it at $500,000, use your house as free marketing to pick up new buyers and not really care if your house sells. And ultimately, if it sells, it sells. If it doesn't, it doesn't. And they've picked up new clients as a result of having your listing through open houses, through sign calls, through internet leads. And so you want to make sure that the agent has a really close list to sale price and they're not just buying your listing and taking your listing so they can generate new business from it. That's really important and something I've seen a lot in the industry is buying the listing, and whether it's malicious or it's just lack of skill in determining proper valuation of a house, it happens a lot. So you want to make sure you ask that agent, what is their list to sale price? And you want that really close to 100%. The last question, number 10, is how will we communicate? I can just say when I sold my house years ago, the agent I used would call me weekly, numerous times a week, and I would just dread his calls because he would just go on and on and on and on and on. And at the end of the call, every time I would just not even know what we were talking about. You want to make sure that the agent is communicating in a way that you want and that works for you rather than a way that they want and that works for them. So there you have it. Those are the 10 questions you should be asking an agent when interviewing for the job of selling your house. Be sure to reach out if you have any home buying, selling, or investing questions.